This video goes with section 14 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course and covers the first declension. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn, pages 21 to 24, for their coverage of the material, which they revisit in the appendix, pages 622 to 624. This introduction to the first declension teaches you how to form words that end in eta or long alpha. There will be more kinds, but not right now. Our examples are techne, technes, he, the word for skill or art, and chora, choras, he, the word for land or country. Just like in the vocabulary list, glossaries, and dictionaries, what you get is the word in the nominative singular, the genitive singular, and the article, which is how we show, conventionally, whether a noun is masculine, feminine, or neuter. Most, but not all, of the first declension is feminine, and both techne and chora are feminine, and so they have the feminine article he. We're going to be adding endings to the stems of these words. To get the stem of a noun in Greek first declension, go to the genitive, that second word, and take off the ais or the as. With these two words, you'd get the same result if you took the ending off the nominative, but that won't always be the case. Now we need to have endings to add to those stems. We'll make a chart for the singular and the plural. Greek has dual too, but it's rare enough not to teach it to you right now. We'll need the nominative, which we used for the subject of a sentence and things that agree with it, the genitive, which will do lots of things, including possession and other uses that can often be translated by the English word of, and it's used as the object of some prepositions. We need the dative, which will also do lots of things, including indirect objects and other uses that can often be translated by the English words to or for, and it's used as the object of some prepositions. We'll need the accusative, which will do lots of things, and especially direct objects, and it's used as the objects of even more prepositions. And we'll learn the vocative, which is only used for direct address when you're calling out to something or someone. Here are the endings of the first declension nouns ending in eta: a, ace, a, ain, a, I, own, ice, us, and I. Nouns have persistent accent. The accent wants to stay the same type in the same place as it is on the nominative singular form of the word. In the first declension, there's an exception. All genitives plural have a circumflex over the omega of the ending. Now you need the endings for the first declension nouns ending in long alpha. They are a, us, a, on, a, and I'm happy to say that the plural of the first declension is the same for long alpha nouns and for eta nouns, as it will be for other variations of the first declension that you'll learn later. You do need to be careful about confusion between the long alpha genitive singular and the accusative plural, because they have the same form. Context will tell you which is which. Now, let's put these things together for techne and chora. Here are our stems, and here are our endings. We'll take the stems and add the endings. Here are all of the stems laid out for us, and now let's add the endings. Techne, technes, techne, technein, techne, technai, technon, technais, technas, and technai. And the accents. Trying to stay an acute on that epsilon, which it can everywhere except that exceptional genitive plural. There we have techne, skill, technes, of skill, techne, which I see is missing its iota subscript, for the skill, technein for the direct object, techne, when you need to talk to your skill, technai, skills, technon, of the skills, technice, for the skills, technos, skills, and technai, addressing skills. Now let's do the same for hora. Here are the stems all laid out for us, and now let's add the endings. Hora, horas, hora, with its proper Yoda subscript, horan, hora, horai, horon, horais, horas, and horai. And the accents, trying to stay an acute on the omega. And that's perfectly fine until we get to the nominative plural. What's happening here is that the accent wants to be over the second to last syllable, which is long, and the last syllable is short. Remember that alpha iota at the end of a word is short for the purposes of accent. And so the circumflex rule comes into play, and we get a circumflex over the omega. Here we have the exceptional genitive plural, and then we get the circumflex rule again in the vocative plural. And so we have chora, land, choras, of land, chora, for land, choran, land as a direct object, chora, when you need to talk to your land, chorai, lands, choron, of lands, chorais, for lands, choras, lands, and chorai, lands. Let's try this again with two other nouns. Oh, sorry. Notice again that the genitive singular and the accusative plural look the same. Now let's try this with two other nouns. Psuche, soul, and agora, marketplace. Here are the stems with the ace and the as taken off the genitives. Here are the endings and our rule and our chart. And now the stems for soul laid out for us. And let's add the endings. Psuche, psuches, psuche, psuchein, psuche, psuchai, psuchon, psuchais, psuchas, psuchai. And the accents. Trying to stay an acute or grave on that eta, but I get to introduce you to a new exception to the rules for accent. In first and second declension nouns and adjectives with an acute on the ultima, the accent changes to a circumflex in the genitive and dative. So here we have soul, psuche, of soul, psuches, for soul, psuche, soul, psuchein, and soul, when you're talking to your soul, psuche. In the plural, psuchai, souls, psuchon, of souls, psuchais, for souls, psuchas, souls as a direct object, and psuchai, when you need to talk to more than one soul. Now, let's do agora. Here are the stems laid out for us, and we add the endings. Again, long alpha ones, agora, agoras, agora, agoron, agora, agorai, agoron, agorais, agoras, and agorai. And the accents, trying to stay an acute or grave on that last alpha, and we see the same exception to the rules for accent, that the accent changes to a circumflex in the genitive and the dative. And so there we have agora, marketplace, agoras, of marketplace, agora, for marketplace, agoran, marketplace, agora, addressing your marketplace, agorai, marketplaces, agoron, of marketplaces, agorais, for marketplaces, agoras, when you need it in the direct object, and agorai, addressing more than one marketplace. You can see that this time the rules for accent actually help you see the difference between genitive singular and accusative plural with a long alpha noun, since the genitive will have that circumflex when you meet a noun that has an acute on the last syllable. That's what you need to know about the first declension. And you should be able to put it into practice in drills, in class, and in translation.